A lot of you have asked about how to do the particle dissolve effect, like in the Avengers movie where people evaporated into thin air. Well, today I'm going to show you how. Are you ready? Okay. Come on! This is Filmora! Avengers is a multi-million dollar movie! What, did you think I was going to snap my fingers like Thanos and suddenly...
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
This effect took me a while to figure out how to replicate in Filmora, but let me show you exactly how I did it. First, I filmed two pieces of footage, one of me reading my lines and then another of just the set without me in it. I brought those two pieces of footage into Filmora 9. Now, you'll need to download a very specific free Filmora effects pack from the Filmora website to create this particle dissolve. It's one of my favorites. It's called the Martial Arts Pack. I'll leave a link in the description below, and I'll also link my video showing exactly how to get that free effects pack at the end of this video, so be sure to watch to the end. I brought the footage of myself into the timeline, and I cut it right at the end where I pretended to be dissolving into dust. I then took the footage of the set without me in it and put that right after it in the same track. The first step of this effect is to bring down the erase transition and drop it right where those two tracks connect. When you do this, you can adjust the speed at which the erase happens. We're doing our best to imitate an extremely sophisticated and painstaking effect, so for our purposes, having it move a little quicker actually helps the effect seem a little more believable. I actually used a little trick to help this effect out. My camera was set to autofocus, so while I was in shot, it focused on me in the first clip, and on the background in the second. So for the shot without me in it, I just moved my hand around in front of the lens, let the camera focus on that, and then pulled my hand away quickly. That gave me a piece of footage with the background looking more like that of my first clip, but then once my hand was removed, the autofocus switched and zeroed in on the background instead. Now this might seem silly or pointless, but once I put the two clips together and I was erased by the transition, it made it seem like the camera was originally focused on me, that I had disappeared, and then the camera decided to switch focus to the background instead. It's just a little simple added layer that subconsciously helps sell the overall effect once you put it all together. Now for the next step, open up Elements and bring down one of the Petals overlays from the Martial Arts Pack. These are actually designed to look like flower petals blowing in the wind, but with a little tweaking, we can make them look like dust or ash. They're all way too colorful for what we're doing, so to eliminate the color from them, click on the element and then in the upper left, click on Color, and then in the White Balance and Tone Controls, pull all of those sliders all the way down to the left. Then in the 3D LUT window, just below that, select the black and white film option. This will make all those petals turn black and look more like floating ash. I actually played with mine a bit and made some of them a little bit lighter, so that some of them looked more like they were reflecting light as they floated around. Now here's where it gets a little tricky. The beginning of this petals element starts kind of slowly, so I split it right where the petals are really starting to fly and I deleted the beginning. Then I sped up the petal element clip to about double its natural speed so that it fits the effect a little bit better. Next, you'll need to lock your main video track so that it can't be moved. Scroll over to where the erase transition begins on your timeline and click up on the preview window. Now you'll have control of the petals element. Click and move that over and align it right to where you start seeing yourself disappear. This will make it seem like right where you're disappearing, the ash is starting to appear and start blowing out into the wind. I use several layers of these petal elements because they all look and move slightly different. You'll want to line them up in a stagger on separate tracks, each one starting a little more to the right as the erase transition moves across your body or face. You can get really crazy and even use the motion effects on these petals to make them swirl around the screen a bit more. It's completely up to you how many layers you want to add and how you want them to move to get your desired effect. After that, I just added a few sound effects like a gust of wind and the sound of rustling leaves to really help sell that effect. I put a little ominous music underneath and voila. Particle dissolve. Hey, wait, I'm not all the way back. come on. Oh, that's better. Peace.